strong father whose son was responsible for the barbadi of Barbad Bunker. How you're feeling just standing few meters away from a place your son sacrificed his life to ensure safety, security and integrity of the country?
I am feeling like going there, but there's no way I can go unless I am taken there. So my first emotion is of going there, seeing each and every step that he took, what all he did. I have heard all those things, but where, how, what, all that he went through, I would like to go and see.
Any special thing which you remember about your son while the war was going on? Because it was the indomitable spirit of all these youngsters who stood like a rock before them.
Alright. There are so many small things that have not come in your channels and your reporting. Right there, what you see, at the end of the fight, there was a trench in which there were two or three Pakistanis. More, as best as I know, there were two of them. And these people, they were assaulting. They were firing. And when they were firing, every time they asked them to surrender, not to kill them, but to capture them. But those guys will lift one hand, then the other hand, and these guys got jittery that they might throw a grenade or something. And at that moment of time, from all round firing started, and those two chaps were killed. So that was the incident over there. And thereafter, after having captured all this, they went into the Pakistani ration store. Very interesting thing, I'm going to tell you. Very ration store was stocked very well with American supplies, tinned fruit, and all kinds of nice things. So they decided to have, firstly, they were very cold, so they lit the water tins and to warm themselves. Then they took those milkmaid milk, that condensed milk, and Major Acharya and Captain Thapar. Then they mixed the two and had a great feast over there. And in the morning when Acharya and he, there's a photo, they were airing their shoes, you know, they were full of sweat. They were airing their feet. On sitting on a bunker, there were dead Pakistanis lying around. And at the base of the bunker was the captured weapons, whole lot of them displayed. And then Ravindranath came. And promptly my son was never short of chocolates. He always kept them, fished them out and gave. So Sio was happy, these guys were happy.
He was not only a courageous soldier but a noble soul, because at that point of time when he was facing enemy, he was worried and concerned about the young girl he had adopted. Can you tell us about that young girl? And still, I am told that you are taking care of both the education and everything about that young girl from Kashmir Valley.
Actually, he didn't adopt her, but he was moved by her state. So he ordered, he requested, and he pleaded in his last interview that you look after this girl by at least paying a school fee of 50 rupees. So I'm doing that, and I will be continuing to do that as long as it's required.
One last question. At a time when everything is so politicized in Kashmir, there are elements who try to demonize armed forces, and here had been a soldier who was fighting against the enemy, and his father till date is supporting a young girl from Kashmir Valley. So what really want to tell them, people like those who are trying to portray forces in that light?
No, the people who are trying to portray the armed forces in poor light are the people who want to butter their slice on both the sides. They want to run with the hounds and play with the hare. That doesn't happen. So, I'll tell them that if they keep the interest of the armed Kashmiri in mind, then they should change the stance and look at the truth. The army is there for the people, always and every time.
Thank you so much for talking to Times.
My pleasure.